Hello everyone, you are watching Data Science Community channel. Today I'll discuss financial derivatives and their types. So let's begin the video. First of all, we need to understand what are derivatives in finance. Derivative is basically a financial contract which derives its value from an underlying asset. The important point is that the buyer agrees to purchase the asset on a specific date and price is also specified. The benefits of such type of contracts are understood by different types of derivatives, which we will discuss in this video. Here, assets include commodities, stocks, bonds, and currencies. Financial derivatives are used in all these assets. Next up, we need to know is the purpose of derivatives, that is risk minimization, which is specifically termed as hedging. Moving forward to see how many types of derivatives are there and how they are used in real time. As you can see, the four basic and important derivatives used in the field of finance are futures, forwards, options, and swaps. These are termed as derivatives instruments. Financial derivatives are exchange over stock exchange, which are termed as exchange traded derivatives, and also they are traded directly on over-the-counter market. Now let's discuss the types of derivatives one by one. The first one is futures. That is an agreement between two parties to buy or sell an asset at a certain time at a certain price. For this, let's assume an example that today is 12th of May 2021 and you have decided to buy stocks of a company on 13th of May 2022. And its price per share at the current time is 40 rupees and you have specified that after 1 year you will buy these stocks at the same price, then this is basically a future contract. The basic objective of future contract is also to hedge against the risk. Like in this example, we have already settled all the conditions to protect ourselves from the price movement of stock. Furthermore, future contracts are traded in stock exchange. That is why they are less risky because of automated settlements. The most important feature of these contracts is that they are standardized. Now the next type of financial derivative is forward contract. That is also equivalent to future contract, but there are some differences which I am going to discuss by splitting the definition. A forward contract is basically a non-standardized contract between two parties to buy or sell an asset at a specified future time and at a price agreed upon today. Here the different feature is being non-standardized means that they are traded over the counter market. The forward contracts are generally used to hedge risk in commodities, interest rate, exchange rate, or equities. Next type of derivative is swap. That is actually a contract between two parties agreeing to trade loan terms. So generally they are used in case of loans, but the question is how. So to answer this, we need to understand it by considering an example of home loan. We have two options of interest rate, which may be a variable interest rate or a fixed interest rate in borrowing a home loan. And a person might seek to switch their variable interest rate loan with someone else who has a loan with a fixed interest rate that is otherwise same. Here, the loan will remain in the original holder's name, but the swap contract requires that each party will make payment toward the other's loan at a mutually agreed upon rate. Generally, swaps can be more risky because if one party defaults or goes bankrupt, the other will be forced back into their own original loan. The fourth and the last important derivative is option. That is also similar to future contracts in a way that it is an agreement between two parties where one party has the opportunity to buy or sell a security. That is basically the major difference between options and futures, that option contract give the option to either buy or sell the asset at a certain price and date. Lastly, we have two types of options. One is call option and the other is put option. Call option actually give buyer the right but not the obligation to buy underlying asset, whereas put option give buyer the right to sell it. One of the most important thing is that all option contracts are settled in the form of cash. And with this, the lecture is over now, and thank you for watching. Have a good time.